The new physical activity guidelines for Americans recommend that adults get 150 to 300 minutes of moderate intensity aerobic activity or 75 to 150 minutes of vigorous intensity aerobic activity per week. But what does that mean? Aerobic physical activities increase heart rate and breathing. Both moderate and vigorous activities count, but vigorous intensity is more strenuous than moderate intensity. However, it gets you to your target in half the time. Moderate intensity activity might seem challenging to someone just starting out. It's okay to start slow and gradually ramp up the intensity over time. So what can you do on a daily basis to get to the recommended amount of activity? Let's get moving and do the math. Walking is the easiest way to get started, but it has to be 2.5 miles an hour or faster. Apps like Google or Apple Maps estimate your arrival time with a walking speed slightly faster than that, so use their ETA as a benchmark. Introduce a 5-minute walk each morning as part of your commute. It's a moderate intensity activity and the minutes add up, totaling 17% by the end of the work week. Leave the car in the garage and walk to the grocery store. If it's 10 minutes away, one trip there and back per week earns you another 13%. Raking leaves is also a moderate intensity activity. 30 minutes of similar yard work or gardening gets you 20% closer to your weekly goal. Taking the stairs is vigorous activity, meaning those minutes add up twice as fast. So skip the elevator because 1 minute of stair climbing every day adds another 9% to your total. Biking 10 miles an hour or faster is also vigorous activity, and just 10 minutes once a week is 13%. If you're really moving, dancing can be vigorous intensity activity. 30 minutes on a Friday night will get you 40%. So at the end of 1 week, where would that get you? Let's add up all those moderate activities. Now adding in our vigorous activities. Goal achieved. The guidelines also recommend muscle strengthening activities on 2 or more days a week. It's important to work all the major muscle groups of the body: the legs, hips, back, abdomen, chest, shoulders, and arms. And for additional health benefits, go beyond these recommendations. But the important thing to remember is that introducing small changes and short routines that get you active can improve your health. And walking is a good first step. If you have a disability or chronic health condition, are older or are pregnant, there are specific recommendations in the guidelines just for you. Click the link in the description to learn more.